So we'll compare Land Acquisition Act with Land Bill 2015 in the same points. So first I will tell you what was the provision in Land Acquisition Act 2013. Then I'll tell you what was the provision in Land Bill 2015. So we'll discuss four or five points. So we'll compare these two. And then finally we will come into the conclusion. So write the first point. Now we will compare Land Acquisition Act 2013 with the Land Acquisition Bill 2015. Number one point, just listen. So under this particular thing, consent requirement. What's the meaning of consent requirement? Consent requirement of the people. So 80% if there is any private project. And 70% if the project belongs to PPP. So the project is public-private partnership. Then the consent requirement of the affected people, like for example, there are 100 people living or 100 households living in the particular village. Then if you are taking that land in that particular village, if the government thinks that we will acquire that particular village. So among 100 households, 70 households should give their consent in the written form. Then the government will be able to acquire the land. Getting my point? So you write this. Consent requirement for project affected people. Consent requirement for the project affected people. Eighty percent for private projects, and 70% for public-private partnership. समझ में आया ना आपको? So this was mentioned in the Land Act 2013. Now, what do you think? Is it good or bad? Is it justified?
It's justified, but it is very difficult to
obtain. It means from the developer's point of view, because we have to think from both perspectives. So it is very, very difficult. From the developer's perspective, private players were not happy. And they were saying that the consent requirement is very high. Very, very high. Because whenever you think about taking land in a rural area, people were very reluctant. Because obviously, no one wants to give their homeland. Aap bhi nahi chahoge. If you want adequate or more than adequate compensation. And after that, you will not be happy. You'll get the money, but you'll not be happy. But because in India, there are certain attachment to the land. People are not ready to sell their home. Barso purana hai dada ji ke time se, nahi bechna chahte, emotional attachment. Hota hai. So consent requirement is very high. So it is very difficult to get the projects. What happened? This government came, launched Make in India. For Make in India, you have to provide land. There was some problem. That is why this government introduced Amendment Bill 2015. So you write one line. From the developer's point of view, the consent requirement was very high. And they were not happy. ठीक है, फुल स्टॉप. नाउ जस्ट लिसन. सो इन द बिल 2015, लिखना नहीं है ठीक, लिख लिया. सो इन द बिल ऑफ 2015, गवर्नमेंट एग्जेम्प्टेड फ्यू आइटम्स, फ्यू कैटेगरीज, दैट इफ गवर्नमेंट वॉन्ट्स टू एक्वायर लैंड फॉर दीज फाइव कैटेगरीज, then these categories are exempted from consent requirement. Exempted. Very controversial. It means it is without consent. So these five items, you write first one. You write, in the Land Acquisition Bill 2015, in the Land Acquisition Bill 2015, government exempted five categories, government exempted five categories from the process of consent requirement. From the process of consent requirement. From the process of consent requirement. Just to facilitate India's flagship program as well as ease of doing business in India. India's flagship program as well as ease of doing business in India. So, right, these five categories are as follows. These five categories are as follows. First one, you write first. Defense acquisition. Defense acquisition. Second one. Acquisition for rural infrastructure. Acquisition for rural infrastructure. Next point. Acquisition for affordable housing. Next point. Acquisition for industrial corridors. Last one. Acquisition for infrastructure. Where central government owns the land. Acquisition for infrastructure where central government owns the land. What do you think so? If you read, these five categories are exempted from consent requirement.
Why do they need the consent if the land already belongs to the central government?
I think I'll explain the fifth point later. But when you think about first three points, maybe justifiable. But if you read the fourth point, that is obviously very, very controversial. If you know the term crony capitalism, that justified the term crony capitalism. Consent requirement exempted for industrial corridor. This was the main debate in the parliament. So Land Acquisition Amendment Bill 2015 is a most controversial clause. Now the last point, where central government owns the land, if central government wants to expand that particular area, then there is no consent requirement. Suppose ONGC is having a plant of this size. Obviously, whenever you will find that if there is any public sector undertakings located, then the local economy started building up. If government wants to expand this particular area, then it is exempted under this bill. I hope you get the idea. What about first one? Justified, no doubt. National security is the most important thing. If in the question, you will see the conflict between national security and human rights, what will you choose?
National security.
Always national security. Human rights will come later. National security is the most important. So here, obviously defense is justified. Second one is your rural infrastructure. Obviously it is a vague statement. You can make flyovers of world-class quality in a village and you will say this is building rural infrastructure. But on the other side, you are connecting two big cities. Getting my bullet train. Now you know that if there is a concept of bullet train will go directly. Obviously they will try to make that track as straight as possible in order to achieve the speed of 350 km per hour. The track should be straight. If there are curves, etc., obviously it is very difficult to achieve that speed. So what will you do? Whatever the amount of land, whatever the category of land will come in front of this track, you will acquire that land. Even that is fertile, non-fertile, etc. So that's the main reason. So for that purpose, government also did this. Third one was affordable housing for rural areas. So affordable housing is obviously not a bad thing, but again, that is undefined. But fourth one was very, very controversial. You know why? Industrial corridor. They're taking land from rural areas and giving to big industries. That created havoc in the parliament as well as in media and experts. Okay, so you write the second point. Second provision will compare that Act of 2013 and Bill of 2015. Second one is social impact assessment. What do you understand by this term, social impact assessment? Have you ever heard about environmental impact assessment? You must have heard about an environment. What's the meaning of that? What is social impact? Yesterday, Rashid sir and I was traveling in metro. We were thinking about that. We were traveling for 1.5 hours in metro. So you can imagine that how far we were traveling. So we were seeing that there was a lot of congestion on the road. So we were fortunate that a motor was not from in taxi, etc. So thinking that metro is very beneficial for Delhi. If we shut down metro for one single day, what will be the impact? Obviously impact on the congestion as well as on the pollution level. Because metro is very helpful in reducing the pollution. Jitne log metro se aa rahe hain, wo two wheelers se jaate. So that is what we call social impact assessment. So what was the impact on society? What is the impact of metro on environment? After building metro, you are feeling that air that you breathe in Delhi is far better if metro would have been not there. So social impact assessment means the impact of that particular project on the society. If you built a dam in a particular area, what will be the impact of that particular dam in the nearby area? Like if you remember that in the second five-year plan, we were discussing that India invested a heavy amount in industries. We were building three industries, Bhilai, Rourkela and Durgapur. Now you can see the development of areas near Bhilai. Raipur, Durg, these are big areas. So just because of that particular industry, surrounding areas started developing. Social impact assessment of any project has to be done before the acquisition of the land. So under you, right? Under the Land Act.
But this impact assessment, how can it be done
prior to the project? There are formulas. Cost benefit analysis is one of the formula in economics. There are project valuation theories. So whenever in economics optional, there are theories, or maybe in Indian Economic Service, they ask that how will you evaluate social impact assessment? There are certain kind of models built by economists. And according to these models, we put things like cost benefit analysis. You understand, in a layman language, cost benefit analysis means if you are investing some amount of money in the business, you will take care of cost, then you will think about benefit in the future. Then you will invest in the economy. So that is cost benefit analysis, to understand the future expectation of your business. On the same lines, there are formulas of measuring social impact assessment.
Actually, who are the stakeholders in this?
Government. Only government. Government officials do this. And private can also do this if private is acquiring these lands. And this social impact assessment you have to provide at the time of consent requirement. That's a compulsion. So you're right. Social impact assessment is done for the project affected people, is done for the project affected people. Full stop. You write SIA. SIA was compulsory under Land Acquisition Act 2013. SIA, it means social impact assessment, was compulsory under the Land Acquisition Act 2013. Full stop. According to Land Bill 2015, according to Land Bill 2015, SIA is a complex process. And causes delays in clearances. Because It first creates report, then goes to the government approval, then for the clearance of the project, and at last acquisition has taken place. Full stop. So what do you think? Just understand. What do you think about the land bill? What will you do in the land bill to facilitate this problem? What will you do? Suppose you are the part of policy making. What will you do to ease out this problem? Because on the one hand, we are talking about single window clearance, etc., ease of doing business. And on the other hand, you have to take care of the people affected in a particular area. So you have to bring the balance between these two. So what will you do? Batao, yehi sab aata hai. There is an opportunity to discuss. Socho, ye sab to books mein, newspaper mein mil jayega aapko. But the question.
Just like the environment impact assessment, there has been a proposal that it should be made like third party environment impact assessment.
It is
done by the government. Theek hai. Third party, so that it is better, it is quicker.
Independent evaluation.
Same can be applied.
Okay, we can say that because we have initiated this model in terms of valuation of non-performing assets. If you remember the discussion of NPA, we were discussing that the evaluation of sustainable and unsustainable assets should be done by an independent agency, whatever it is, not by RBI, not by government, not by bank. That is done by some third party. So that's a good point. Other things? What will you do to expedite the process? Any idea? यही पूछा जाता है mains में, जिसके पास सरकार के पास भी solution नहीं है. हमेशा ध्यान रखना. When there is no solution, the question will come in UPSC. पूछते हैं ना, what do you think about this, this, this? In conclusion, you have to write something extra, because everybody is reading newspaper, The Hindu or either Indian Express. Everyone is having same points. So you have to give something extra in the answer to gain or to fetch extra marks. So first you write what was the provision in this bill. So write. So in the bill 2015. So in the bill of 2015, government exempted the above mentioned five categories. Government exempted above mentioned five categories from social impact assessment. From social impact assessment. So what do you think? Is this a correct solution? No. This is a good solution. Like for example, but if you are grabbing some land that is for industry, for defense, for polluted industry, non-pollution industry, whatever it is, but it's all about land, it's not about environment. So people will be get affected from that particular land. Unko to relocate karna hi padega.
But sir, they are given like job facilities in that. In the case of Nelopan, there was according to the statement, but when he was set up in Gujarat, they provide job facilities to the people who were relocated.
Same thing happened in Kodankulam case. Kodankulam nuclear power plant. There were fishermen affected by the cooling water, that hot water they were discharging in the sea. So what happened to the fishes in the nearby sea? So the particular objection was also raised by Sri Lankan government of Kodankulam nuclear power plant, because nuclear power plant is location based. It will not think about the nearby areas, and you have to vacate all the nearby areas of the nuclear power plant because of any risk in the future. So there are many solutions, but main solution obviously is not that we should exempt these five sectors from social impact assessment. We just have to expedite the situation by having more personnel engaged in it, by having more tools for that. Like for example, if you are grabbing or if you are acquiring certain agriculture land, then you make this assessment, particularly from satellite mapping, that this agriculture land is fertile. Getting my point? So with the base of new technology, etc., you can expedite the situation, but exemption of this social impact assessment is not the solution. We have to think about expediting this particular situation. That's the main reason. Because eliminating that particular provision is not the solution. We have to expedite, provide more personnel, take social impact assessment as the priority. Government generally do not take SIA as the priority. So this is the solution. Okay. You write the next point, third point.
What is the solution for for it being a very time consuming process. That is the main reason that they are
they're exempting.
Yes.
So we can exempt for defense only. For other things, they will say that there is some timeline, like in insolvency and bankruptcy code, there is timeline for the resolution, 180 days. In passport verification, now there is a timeline, 15 days. So should give the timeline. In land acquisition, there is no timeline. That is the solution. So we can take from other provisions of the other facilities provided by the government. Because social impact assessment, the exemption of it is not the solution, obviously. This is an unanimous decision. So this was also one of the controversial provision of this bill of 2015.
So, I was reading somewhere that earlier the process was 5 years to administer and do other, and if someone objected, then the meaning of the other impact needs. But now, with the single bit of the layers, the 5 years to administer.